choose a beautiful green spot to build a house on, the very spot the fairies loved best. The neighbor warned him that it was very rough, but he laughed and never minded, for he was from the north and looked on such things as mere old wives' tales. So he built the house and made it beautiful to live in, and no people in the country was so well off as the Johnstones. The farmer for taking away Trouble. Mauricia flexuosa. A palm with a thousand uses. Mauricia flexuosa is a tall palm tree and therefore a type of giant grass. Native to the rainforest and found along the banks of the Amazon in marshland known as Buritises or Veredas. Over the course of several months per year, female palm trees yield a large quantity of clustered at the top of the stem, a false trunk. They are protected by a shell that looks like a wonderful dragon egg in the jungle. Teachings from the immemorial. In the Cerrado operation of central Brazil, the Buriti, or tree of life, to the locals, is sacred. Humans enjoy the fruit as much as macaws, iguana, and fish, who fed off it happily. Pollination is performed by local bees and small flies. Its leaves and strong fibers are braided and used to make roof, baskets or hats. Young leaves are so supple and thin that they are nicknamed Buriti silk. Musical instruments are carved from the wood of its stem. In the Apinaye tribe, men who are about to be married must prove their strength and skill by carving a chest out of a section of the stem in the Amazon rainforest. The ripening of the fruit is a cause for celebration and is also considered to be an auspicious time for weddings. The fruit's bright orange pulp, high in vitamin C, is pressed in order to extract the juice. The pulp can be cooked into compote or jams. Once fermented, the sap yields a popular type of alcohol, the vino di Buriti. The star tree. History informs us that the Cerrado was peopled by several indigenous tribes. Among them, the most respected was ruled by the Irapa Irana. Son zèle, la pauvre bête ne s'interrompait jamais. La seconde oie entonna le même refrain, puis la troisième, puis la quatrième, puis enfin toute la troupe, de sorte qu'il n'y eut bientôt plus qu'un concert de cara, cara, cara. Et Maître Renard, qui avait donné sa parole, dut attendre qu'elles eurent fini leur caquetage. Nous devrons faire comme lui pour connaître la suite de ce conte. Cette vidéo vous a plu, vous pouvez la liker et vous abonner.